Hi, you guys. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Brad. This is the Firefighters Financial Toolbox. I always tell you it's important to have goals. So I'm going to talk a little bit about how training for sports and how competing in sports can be like investing. Now, I understand that sounds kind of far-fetched, but indulge me a second. So not only do I compete in Masters Weightlifting, I also am a coach of a Masters Weightlifting team. Now, for those of you who don't understand master sports, it starts at 35 and it goes until however old. And it's broken down into 5-year age categories. For example, I'm in the 50 to 54 group, and then I would move to 55 to 59. On my team, I have athletes from 35 years old all the way up to the two oldest, who are 70 and 71. Now, at 71, it's hard to learn new tricks, if you want to say. But I have two athletes who are very, very motivated. And for me, the thing they told me, and this is where I equate it to investing, they said the hardest thing about making the decision was starting. Starting to train for weightlifting. They decided they wanted to do it. They picked a competition that they wanted and they trained for it. They made the commitment to start. And then they stayed with it, and consistently we practiced and practiced and practiced, and they went on to compete. Now, as a coach, my proudest moment thus far was having two of my athletes, one who was 70 and one who was in his 60s, both take silvers in national level competitions. For me, that's the most rewarding thing, you guys. I compete at a national and international level, and to have these athletes that started with me from ground zero, to get all the way up to the point where they could compete at a national level. Now, granted, there aren't as many national level masters athletes in weightlifting as some sports, but still, they had a goal, they trained for it, and they made it. Investing is the same way, you guys, and in the same respect, the hardest thing really about investing is starting. If you can make the commitment to start investing, and particularly start investing younger, the more time you'll have to perfect it, to make that long-term goal of retirement, or maybe you're saving for a new house down payment. Whatever the goal is, you guys, making the commitment to start saving and start investing is the hardest part. Once you do, you make it, you put it on autopilot. Maybe you contribute to every paycheck, or maybe you contribute once a month to your Roth IRA. Whatever it is, you guys, it's just like when you're training, you consistently keep adding money to that account with the goal that someday I'll be able to retire, or someday I'll be able to reach financial independence and maybe retire early. That sounds good. But the biggest obstacle for most people is the first step, you guys, getting started. Just like these guys told me in weightlifting, it was a fear of trying something new, a fear of failure, a fear of messing up. And it's okay to have those fears, because you know what? You're gonna mess up. But all you have to do in investing is start, pick a vanilla ETF like VTI or VOO, get some broad diversification, and just keep adding money to it. And as it grows, you're gonna feel better about it, and you're gonna wanna put more money in to see that process get better and better and better. So that hopefully someday your long-term goal of retiring early, or retiring and not having to worry about running out of money, that can be a realistic goal. Now guys, I wanna apologize. I just got done training with my team, and today looks to be one of the hottest days in Oregon thus far. So that's why I'm in a tank top. Forgive me for that, but it's too nice not to be outside. Anyway, you guys, get started. Don't be afraid to take that first step. Don't be afraid to have goals. Whatever they are, pick a goal and go get it. All right, you guys, hope you got something out of this. If you did, drop me a like. It really helps the algorithm. If you're not already subscribed, you guys, hit the button, ring the bell. Become part of the community. All right, thanks a lot. We'll see you.